Today's topic is Mother Kali. As worship of Mother Kali is just in a few days, we are worshipping Mother Kali on 26th of October at 6:30 p.m. in the Kali temple, Kalibadi. The Mother's worship is on 25th of October. So to have the idea of Mother Kali fresh, and particularly for the devotees of Sri Ramakrishna, Mother Kali has a special place in their heart, because Kali was the chosen ideal of Sri Ramakrishna. Let us start from what we generally understand by Mother Kali. We often see the picture of Kali looking like fierce, terrible sometimes. If you recall the picture, she is standing on the chest, her right foot on the chest of Shiva, her consort. And she is with her disabled hair, her body is not covered with clothes. There is a girdle of arms at her waist, and she has four arms herself. And with two left hands are sword on the upper hand, and one decapitated head with blood dripping out is on the lower left hand. And on her right hand, she is quite different. She is giving boon with her right left hand and fearlessness from the upper hand. With right lower hand giving boon and right upper hand giving fearlessness. So that is the form of Mother Kali, with her tongue protruding, black in color, and with jackal. Sometimes you'll find when a jackal drinking the blood that is flowing from the decapitated head, and the sword has the freshly smeared blood on it. So a terrible form, not exactly terrible, but terrible on one side, benign on one side. And what does this all this signify, the Mother Kali? Why God should be so fierce looking, so terrible? Some feel that, why sword and blood and this thing? But Mother Kali represents to the devotees is quite different. It doesn't matter, they don't see her terrible at all. She is all mother, all blissfulness, all benign. For a devotee, there is no blood, there is no killing. There is only grace, there is only protection, there is only boon of mother. So mother in fact represents, how this form came. They say when Shakti at Durga was fighting with the Asuras, a time came when one demon was there, was very difficult to kill. As the mother tried to kill her, from her whatever blood came out, each drop of blood became another Asura. That Asura is called Rakta Bija. Every drop of blood has the power to produce a demon like himself. So Mother Durga kills that Asura, and thousands of Asura come. From every drop one Asura comes. Now what to do? From that Mother Durga's body became angry, and from that body came another Devi who was black with anger. And she drank all the blood before it fell on the ground. Whenever the blood drop fell on the ground, Rakta Bija will be born. But before the blood of the Asura fell on the ground, that was taken away by Mother Kali. So after that, Mother Kali had to protect the creation. And in that rage and anger, she became so angry with everything. She started killing everything that came around. All the Asuras were being killed. And she started dancing the dance of destruction. And then the gods could not stop her. She was so fierce with this rage. Then what? There was no way to calm her down. So then all gods went to Shiva, the consort of Mother, all ever calm, never agitated. Only once he was angry with Kama, and he saw with her third eye the Kama, the lust. The god of lust was burnt to ashes. Only once it happened. Otherwise, he is never angry. Always happy with little small prayer. Little, very few wooden, that wild willow leaf you give, pour some water on his image, on his linga, and Shiva becomes happy. That Shiva was afraid, please save us, we are not able to calm down Mother Kali. So Shiva came and he lied down in that battlefield where there were the corpse and hands and arms were all strewn all around, and jackals and other carrion feeders were moving there, other birds were moving there. Shiva came and quietly lied down like a corpse. And it said that Mother was dancing with the rage and anger, and she in that dance without seeing, she stepped her right foot on the body of Shiva like prostrate on the ground without knowing. After that she realized and she saw her own concern, and she felt, she kept her foot on the body of her concern. It is great sacrilege. And in that she, out of shame on herself, she protruded the tongue, and when we do something wrong, we have a capacity to bite our tongue with our own teeth. That, oh, it was my mistake. Like that, Mother felt that it was her mistake. And that form of Mother, we worship. Shiva lying prostrate on the ground, white colored, pure, calm, supreme Brahman. Mother, the creator of the universe, the destroyer of the universe, the sustainer of the universe, the Mahashakti in the form of Mother Kali, dancing on her, having foot on her chest, on the chest of Shiva. And with the sword just that had killed the demons for the protection of creation, for the protection of good, for the destruction of evil, that always has been there. We want to be protected by someone very strong who can do. So Mother Kali is the one, when even Durga found it difficult to really how to control this Raktabija, came Mother Kali. The final source of protection is Mother Kali. And that is the symbol of Mother, the symbol of strength, symbol of boon, symbol of protection. Mother is supposed to be one of the aspects of three gunas of which this universe is made. And she supposedly, someone represents it, because she is black in color, she represents tamo guna. For some it might be. There are many explanations of Mother's form. Tamo guna is that aspect of the power which destroys. What she destroys, which is tamoguna, she destroys the ignorance of ourselves. Without that destructive power of which can destroy our ignorance, how the knowledge will come? So that's why they said Mahakali, Mahalakshmi, Mahasaraswati. The Divine Mother is depicted in three forms. Mahakali is the destroyer. Destroyer not of the creation. That creation undergo change, that is the nature of Prakriti. But destroyer, and for a spiritual person, she destroys the ignorance. Without destruction of the ignorance and egotism, how can the knowledge dawn? How can God come? So, worship of Kali is necessary for all spiritual practice, whether in this form or by trying to destroy our ego by any other means. But Kali represents the destruction of our ego. Then when the ego is destroyed, then comes Mahalakshmi, who will install the knowledge. And Mahalakshmi comes, and then who will sustain that? Mahasaraswati, then when it is cleared, our heart is cleared of all evils, thoughts and ignorance and egotism, then Mahalakshmi starts installing the knowledge, and final illumination comes through the grace of Mahasaraswati. So Mahakali, Mahalakshmi, Mahasaraswati are the three aspects of Mahashakti, which is depicted as Mother Durga. So these are the different forms that are described. So Kali is in fact the symbol of terrible and also benignness. In her form itself, blood dripping head and garland of human skull, human decapitated head, the girdle of human arms, so it looks so terrible. And at the same time, Mother is blissful. If you see her face, it is as if smiling. Smera nana saro ruham. It's like it says, the Dhyana Mantra of Mother says, your face is smiling in benignness, O Mother. I meditate on that, Mother. And she gives boon, she gives fearlessness, she gives protection. If we are with Mother, we are the worshipper of Mother Kali. We have no fear. All fear goes. She will protect us from all difficulties. That is the worship of Mother Kali. She is the symbol of strength. Now, this Kali is a form of Dasha Mahavidya. The divine Shakti Durga is supposed to have 10 forms of different hues, of different qualities. Kali, Tara, Shodashi, Bhuvaneshwari, Bagala, Chinnamasta, Matangi, Kamala, like the different forms are there of Mother Kali. Kali is the primary of them. So, this what is the explanation? This was the scene that was depicted in the scriptures, how this Mother Kali was formed, how this she came from to protect from the imminent danger of destruction of the universe and conquer of the universe by the evil forces. So Mother Kali was created out of, took the form of the Mahamaya, the Mahashakti, took the form of Mother Kali. Now, let us now try to find what is the philosophy behind that. Why is Mother depicted that way? Let's say first say Kali, her name itself. Her name Kali means comes from the root Kala, from time. Time is very powerful thing. It devours everything. Time makes everything change, come in, retain and then go. So Kali is the one, so time eats, devours everything. With time goes everything. But what is eaten up by time? They say it is Kali which devours even Kala. When there is no time, no space, no time-space causation, then there is Kali. Kali is that. The name supposes that it is, she is greater than the time. Time is her subordinate. That's why she is Kali, the name. Now, her standing on Shiva. Why Shiva she is standing so terrible? Why is she standing on the chest of her husband, as the story goes? But what is the philosophical expression of that? Shiva is the ultimate truth. Shiva is not the being. Shiva is that ultimate truth, ultimate reality, which is beyond creation, transcendent reality. To that reality, we give some form for the sake of meditation, for the sake of worship, for the sake of our thought and prayer. That Shiva, to create this universe, needs power. And Mother Kali is that power. Without Shiva, Mother Kali cannot exist. Mother's existence is not possible without Shiva, without ultimate reality. And Shiva cannot reveal without Mother Kali. Both are complementary to each other. In fact, both are one seen in two different forms. That's why Sri Ramakrishna used to say, when there is creation, we call him. When there is a creation, we call him Kali, Shakti. When that very creation is not there, no differentiation, all is stable, oneness, then I call him Brahman. That Brahman and Kali are same. Seen in two different ways, with two different purposes. What we seek to attain to that reality, changeless, permanent, calm, serene, that ultimate truth, the bliss, Satchidananda, then that same Satchidananda is Mother Kali. There is no difference. So Satchidananda, with the help of the creative power of Satchidananda, is Mother Kali. Creative power of Shiva is Mother Kali. No distinction between them two. Mother Kali's complexion, she is dark blue to black in color. Why God is depicted that way? In fact, you find other than Shiva, all other popular gods in Hinduism have dark colors. Krishna, Rama, all are dark colors. And Mother Kali is almost black in color. Some Dr. Sarkar was there who used to treat Sri Ramakrishna. He was a very skeptic mind person. He didn't believe in rituals and mythology and all that. All he used to think. Be a very good doctor, very glad hearted and good person, but had that sort of thing. And he said one day to him that Kali is Kali is like was a like one tribal woman that was very heroic, and she is being worshipped at Kali. Listening to this, our young Mahendranath Gupta laughed loudly. Then he asked, how did you get this explanation of Mother Kali, that she was some tribal woman? He said, I read somewhere, like that he was saying. So for him, Mother Kali was that, because he couldn't understand the real purport of Mother Kali. Then her complexion being black, Sri Ramakrishna had explanation. He said, you see Mother black in complexion, dark in color, because you are far from Mother. The nearer you reach Mother, you start to understand who this Mahashakti is, who creates this universe, who is that reality. As closer you go to that reality, you find it is, there is no color. And he gives beautiful example from our daily experience. And he says, you see, ocean looks blue from far away. Go near it. Bring a few water in your hands. You'll find there is no color. It's colorless. The sky looks blue when it is far away. But whatever the sky just close to you, it is colorless. Like that he gave the example, how thing seen from far seems dark. Go near it. Go be closer to Mother Kali, closer to the reality, closer to the creative principle of this universe. The creator, Mother Kali is the creator. Then you find her colorless. There is no color, there is no form. All form that is seen of Mother Kali will melt into formless. That is what the spiritual evolution is. We start with some form, and the form, not of our imagination, the form which has been meditated and worshipped by the people, and the form by meditating and worshipping which people had got realization, they got illumination, that form becomes the path traded by others, saints. That becomes our own path. Mahajano yena gata sapantha. With the great personalities, great spiritual persons, trait, that is the path. So, the devotees of Mother Kali had reached that what is Mother Kali. So, is her complexion black means that she is black, seen from far. Come, get closer to her, not to the image, closer to what she represents. Then she is without color. She is without form. She is the ultimate reality. She is not separate from Shiva. She is one with Shiva. She is not other than Brahman. She is one with Brahman. As we go closer in our love for Mother, in our worship of Mother, we could get that. Mother Kali has disabled hair, long hair and all disabled. It says, they are not bound. It represents freedom. She is free. And she is for the freedom of the soul. That is her will. She wants her creation to go, but she becomes very happy when souls get freed from the bondage of samsara. Sri Ramakrishna used to say, it is like a kite, you know, the paper kites being flown in the sky, and when one or two kites just get detached from the thread, then Mother gets clapping and says, see, that has gone, that has become free and becomes happy. She wants the play to go on, but whenever some souls get freed from this bondage of samsara, she is very happy. She doesn't want her play to stop, but she also wants that her devotees are freed from the bondage of samsara. She has three eyes. Human beings have two eyes. Hindu gods and goddesses, the nitya avatar are often shown with three eyes, like Shiva also has three eyes. Two eyes, the normal eyes, we see the world, the third eye is the eye of wisdom, the eye of which sees the reality, because she is always one with the reality, she always sees the reality, that's why Mother has three eyes. She has the red tongue protruding. Why is Mother protruding red tongue? It was also symbolic that we find that she has bitten her red tongue with white teeth. They say one has to transcend tamoguna, then rajaguna, then sattvaguna. So it has to climb up to sattvaguna and finally we need to transcend even sattvaguna. So here Mother says that control your rajaguna or your passion for the action or ambition with the help of sattvaguna by the power of the quality of sereneness, calmness, spirituality. By the power of spirituality, control your passion for activity. The red tongue represents passion for activity or rajaguna, white teeth represents sattvaguna or closeness to spirituality. The four arms, benign and terrible, and that says the Mother, the terrible form of Mother is not for a devotee, but for the evil person. For a devotee, Mother says, if you want to We have the illumination, it's all boon and fearlessness. If you are away from me, if you do the evil things, then comes the other left hand's work. And that work also, the sword also is often represented as to cut the ignorance. It is represented the battle and all that. Battle is in us. So all asuras are all evil that is in us will be cut asunder by the sword in the mother's left hand. What about the left lower left hand which holds the head? It is that one who surrenders to mother, he gets everything. That is a surrendering, giving out knowledge that is also in mother's hand. That same represents the girdle of decapitated arms on her waist. That mother is the source of all our action. So that's why the hands which work are with mother. The brain which thinks, our brain that is also in mother's hand. So our intellect also comes from mother. Our action also comes from mother. But we need to control our passion for the action, passion for the ambition with the help of serenity of the mind. That's what the mother says. Now, what is her dress? She has no dress. She cannot wear anything. Why is shown that without dress? Because mother is infinite. How will one put the dress to infinite? When there is no cloth that can cover her. So that to represent that the infinity of Mother Kali, she is without dress. They say the quarters, the four east, west, north, south are her dress like that. She is so vast, so infinite, no dress can cover her. So there is no dress in her. And she has the garland of decapitated. One head is in left hand, but again she has the garland of heads. If you count the garland of heads on her neck, there is 50 numbers. Why 50? Each head represents one letter of the Sanskrit alphabet. And letter is called in Sanskrit akshara, unchangeable, indestructible. That is the source of, from the letter comes word. Word is the source of the expression of knowledge. Word or akshara represents knowledge. That knowledge, all the knowledge is in her making the garland. So mother is the source of knowledge. All akshara comes from mother. Nothing is terrible. Everything is symbolic in her. That's what the mother's form represents in philosophically. Kali is the embodiment of Mahashakti. Sri Ramakrishna worshipped her in the form. And he had the feeling that mother is living. She wanted to see living mother. And doubt came. Mother, are you living or not? The mother was not responding. I want to see your form. Who are you? So then one day mother was not responding. And one day after a long agony of not seeing her, her not revealing to himself whether he is worshipping the stone statue or real divine presence. It was doubtful for him. He didn't want to take rest. He was not at rest before he finds that it is the real divine presence, living presence that I am worshipping. So one day he felt, no, she is not revealing. Not that, she was not there. She felt she is not revealing. He used to pray, you reveal to Ram Prasad, you reveal to Kamala Kanta, other devotees of yours. Why are you not revealing to me? Then one day it was too much for him and he wanted to end his life. If mother doesn't reveal, there is not worth living in this life. Mother was his sole aim in life. God was his center of life. Nothing else. If God doesn't reveal, why should I live? He wanted to end his life. That time he fell unconscious. And he describes later on that he saw that ocean of light coming towards him in huge waves. He feels his light down and ocean is coming. And then he finds that ocean of light then ultimately came up to him and drowned him. He tried to save himself, he was drowned. After that he said, I didn't know what happened. It was all light in his vision. After a long time he came to consciousness. And when he came to consciousness, he was uttering word, Mother, Mother. It was the vision of mother in formlessness, in the form of light. Not that mother danced with her four hands and garden of hair and decapitated head and sword and blessing and fearlessness. Mother showed her in the form of light, the spiritual illumination, the formless taking the form. Mother became reality after that. Then also question was there, mother, if you are that form, what is the relation of that formlessness with this form that is being worshipped here in the temple? And so he used to test mother, is she breathing? She put cotton near the nostrils, yet it's moved. She is breathing, she is living. She used to feed mother food that was offered. It was living being standing there and accepting his worship as a human being and accept our service. That was mother for Sri Ramakrishna. And Sri Ramakrishna, that's why that's mother divine, the divine being, the supreme reality, the Brahman, the supreme God, taking the form of this image and sitting in the temple was so real to Sri Ramakrishna. Then he asked to mother, mother, you are there in the temple, you gave your graces to give me vision, and but I want to know you, how others worship you. So after that, one after another, the teachers came to reveal how the mother is worshipped by a Vaishnava, how is mother worshipped by a Krishna Bhakta, how is mother worshipped by a Muslim, how is mother worshipped by a Christian. All that came. How is mother worshipped by a Advaiti, who doesn't believe in any duality in creation. And for Sri Ramakrishna, it was that supreme mother being worshipped in different forms. Krishna was mother in another form, Christ was mother in another form, Allah was mother in another form, it was all mother. Finally he realizes, yes, through any path you go, you reach that mother. And after that he started seeing that mother in everything. Everything became full of mother consciousness, divine mother was there. And he said, I see all human beings are divine mother. It seems that mother is like, when a human being comes, it is like mother coming with her face covered. And outside is the face covered with human face, but inside is all divine mother. So whole creation became divine mother for Sri Ramakrishna. Everything was full of divine mother for him. When Advaitin, that Totapuri came, and he didn't believe in Shakti. He believed Brahman is the truth, whole this is just illusion, it can be negated. Nothing exists, it's like a dream. That was the philosophy of Advaita. So Sri Ramakrishna learned from him Advaita Vedanta, attained Nirvikalpa Samadhi in 3 days, that Totapuri was very surprised to see that can happen. For him, it took 40 years of rigorous practice for Sri Ramakrishna, in only 3 days, he could reach that state. And Totapuri, who used to live only 3 days in one place, he stayed on living by the attraction of Sri Ramakrishna and Dakshineswar, days after days, for a few months. And finally, he was meditating one day, and he found his stomach ache. He had control of everything that came to him, physical, mental, he had so great control over himself. That day he wanted to control his pain, but his mind came again on the body. He found there is something that is beyond his control. He was very upset. This body is creating this problem. For him who had realized the truth, body can be thrown away. He went into the Ganga to drown himself and give up the body and merge into that ultimate reality, Advaita Brahman. But to his surprise, Ganga had no sufficient water to drown. Then he said, what is this play? Came to Sri Ramakrishna and said, you see Ramakrishna, I couldn't drown. What happened is? He said, it's all the play of mother. Because you don't accept mother, that's why it's happening this way. Mother is the reality. When you are born as a creature in this world, you have to accept the power which creates. You deny the power. That is impossible. There is ultimate truth. But when you go to in that reality, you merge in samadhi, then you are in that ultimate reality. When you are in the creation, you are under the domain of Mother Kali. That he realized, yes, Shakti is reality, creation is reality. And then he went to the Mother Kali and accepted Mother Kali. It was long before Swami Vivekananda accepted Mother Kali. Swami Vivekananda was a follower of Brahmo Samaj, though he used to visit Sri Ramakrishna, but Brahmo said this image worship is not right thing. And they made him that only God is the reality, which is formless, who is in heaven, and we should pray to God, and God worship in image is not right. You should never go to worship God. Swami Vivekananda fell into great trouble. Didn't visit Kali's temple, though he used to visit Sri Ramakrishna, talk to him, sing to him, but he never stepped a few steps forward and went to his temple because he was supposed not to believe in image worship. That was the Brahmo's philosophy, that God cannot be worshipped in image, God has to be just thought of the presence. Then finally all the difficulties came, he couldn't get job, his parents and his mother and his siblings were unfit, great trouble. Then he came to Sri Ramakrishna, please do something, there is great problem with me, I'm not seeing the way out. So then Sri Ramakrishna says, because you don't accept Mother Kali, that's why this trouble is coming to you. That was his philosophy. Oh, those who accept Mother, no troubles will be there. Those who do not accept Mother, yes, troubles will come to them. Troubles may come. For those who accept Mother, there is a way out. They go to Mother and pray, and troubles are removed. They get the strength. Those who do not accept, whom they will pray? Brahman is the supreme being sitting where we do not know. Whether he sees to us, that also we do not know. That is the reality, that is the presence. But who will take care of us when we are in trouble? It is Mother Divine. Sri Ramakrishna said, go to Mother Kali's temple and pray to her. She will, whatever you ask, she will grant. That much assurance Sri Ramakrishna gave to Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda went there and he was in the presence of God. As Sri Ramakrishna saw God in the presence of God in the divine image of Mother Kali, Swami Vivekananda also could feel the divine presence there when he went there. It was God standing in front of him. Then he couldn't ask for bread and food and clothing. He asked for great things. He said, give me dispassion, give me knowledge, give me devotion for you. Jnana Bhakti Vivek Vairagya. That he asked. Then he came to Sri Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna asked, thrice it happened. Sri Ramakrishna, did you ask Mother for the removal of difficulties? He said, no, I couldn't do that. Sri Ramakrishna said, then why did you ask? I asked this thing. Sri Ramakrishna was so happy that Narendra Nath had accepted Mother Kali. That was Sri Ramakrishna's philosophy. When you are born as a human being, you must accept the Creator, the Kali, the power of Shakti, which governs all our life. So, and he was very happy. That is the philosophy of Hinduism, that divine being as divine mother creates, sustains and absorbs this creation. This creation, when we are in it, is the reality for the time being. It is not the ultimate reality. Ultimate reality is Supreme Brahman, which is actionless, which is creationless, which is the truth, unchanging truth, Satchidananda, bliss itself. But when the creation is there, then there is the Creator, which is governed by God. And best we recall that God is Divine Mother. Think of God as Mother, our taking care person, our sustainer, our who brought us into this world, that Divine Mother, ever present, ever taking care. And Sri Ramakrishna was very happy and he said, don't worry, you will have no problem of simple food and simple clothing. Everything will be all right. So that was, so Sri Ramakrishna was so happy how Swami Vivekananda, Narendranath, when he was Narendranath, accepted Mother Kali. As Totapuri had accepted Mother Kali. And Sri Ramakrishna, Dr. Sarkar once said, like this Kali worshipper, there were so many Tantra worshippers who couldn't really find the truth and they just worship with the, there are Tantra, Tantric practices are very, very difficult. Like to worship in Tantra, the Divine Mother is worshipped with Panchamakara sadhana, take meat and fish and consecrated wine, and then meditate on God, meditate on Mother, take all evil and good together, accept the whole creation as it is. It's very big philosophy, accepting good as well as evil in this creation. So that was the philosophy, but somehow it degraded, everyone couldn't reach that reality and this just fell short of reaching there. So worshippers of Kali were supposed to be not that great person because many were, couldn't reach the goal and they themselves degraded on the path. So that Dr. Sarkar also didn't like the worshippers of Kali. Then he one day conversation on Monday, October 26, 1885, Dr. Sarkar says to Yam, I find that he, meaning Sri Ramakrishna, is a worshipper of Goddess Kali. As if that's not a great thing to do, to worshipping Goddess Kali. Yam knew what Sarkar wants, what is the idea of Mother Kali for Sarkar is, so he explains what Mother Kali means to Sri Ramakrishna. Yam says, but with him, the meaning of Kali is different. What the Vedas call Supreme Brahman, he calls Kali. What the Muslims call Allah and the Christians call God, he calls Kali. He does not see many gods. He sees only one God. What the Brahmajnanis of olden times call Brahman, what the yogis call Atman, and the bhaktas call Bhagavan, he calls Kali. That was Mother Kali for Sri Ramakrishna in ultimate sense. He knew that Mother Kali is the ultimate reality, the creator, and the form that we worship is the symbol of that ultimate reality, ultimate power. Swami Vivekananda said that if you want to reach God, you cannot shun the terrible aspect of this creation. You have to accept the terrible as well as the benign. Then only you can reach God. So he says, describes Mother the terrible, scattering plagues and sorrows, dancing mad with joy. Come, Mother, come, for terror is thy name. Death is in thy breath, and every shaking step destroys the world forever. Thou time, the all-destroyer, come, O Mother, come. Who dares misery love and hug the form of death, dance in destruction's dance, to him the Mother comes. He can understand Mother who is not afraid of anything in this world. However terrible it is, he sees it as a play of Divine Mother. Her creation, she takes up it, her own thing, how to create, sustain and resolve her own way. In the destruction also, one who can see the hand of that Divine, blissful Mother, he will realize the reality when he can accept the terrible destruction as the creation and sustenance. That to him the Mother comes. Our Ramprasad one wrote about Mother Kali. Once someone said, Sri Ramakrishna tells in the gospel that someone put garland on, someone put that sacred thread on Mother Kali's body. Another devotee came and he said, why are you putting sacred thread on Mother Kali's body? She is a feminine deity and women do not wear sacred thread in present times. Then the one who had put that worshipper said, oh, you seem to have understood Mother Kali that she is only feminine. And you say that. But I do not know whether she is male or female. That's why I put sacred thread in her. So Mother Kali is beyond male and female. Ramprasad, who has seen the Mother Kali with beautiful songs and Mother, he says what the Mother is. Who is there that can understand what Mother Kali is? Even the six darshanas are powerless to reveal her. It is she, the scriptures say, that is the inner self of the yogi, who is the self, discovers all his joy. She that of her own sweet will inhabits every living thing. The macrocosm and the microcosm rest in the mother's womb. Now, do you see how vast it is? In the Mooladhara, the yogi meditates on her, and in the Sahasrara, who but Shiva hath beheld her as she really is. Within the lotus wilderness, she sports beside her mate, the swan. When man aspires to understand her, Ramprasad must smile. Who will understand Mother Kali? To think of knowing her, he says, is quite as laughable as to imagine one swimming across the boundless sea. We cannot fully understand Mother Kali. Sri Ramakrishna says, you don't need to fully understand God. Whatever or how much ever you realize you understand God, that is sufficient. If you are intoxicated with one peg of wine, why do you need to know how much of wine is there in the tavern? That's what he says. Little of God, understanding God, makes you overwhelmed. Why do you need to know how the full God is? It is not possible to understand God fully. He also says, it is like crossing the ocean by swimming. Understanding God is not possible. Then he continues. But while my mind has understood that it is not possible to understand Mother Kali, alas, my heart has not. Though but a dwarf, it still would strive to make a captive of the moon. I want to know as much as I can. I want to be merged in her thought. I want to know her more fully and merged in the bliss of Divine Mother. Mother Kali, the depiction of Shakti, in the forearm, protruding tongue, it's difficult for some people to do that terrible form. But that very Mother Kali, that Shakti, becomes human being. Loving, kind, compassionate human being, our own mother. Our mothers are the form of that Divine Mother. And the best manifestation of that Divine Mother Kali is Holy Mother Sarada Devi. Having full qualities of that divinity, some seen, some unseen. Never she expressed herself, her spiritual power, her reality. Very rarely she expressed. But people know that how praying to her, coming to her, how it's fulfilling, how it's absorbing, how much it is close to our heart, that Holy Mother. Shibuda, her nephew, once was walking with Holy Mother and going from Kamarpur to Jairambati with a bundle of cloth and with his body taking the bundle of cloth and going together. He was a little behind, Holy Mother was in front. Suddenly Holy Mother felt that he is not walking. She couldn't hear her footsteps. She turned back. She, who a small boy, was standing behind. Holy Mother said, what happened? Why are you standing? Why are you coming to come on, Jairambati? He said, I have a question. What question you have? Who are you? What is this question? Who am I? Your aunt. Then he said, then you can go. I'll be standing unless you really reveal me who you are. After that, who else? What has come to your mind? Who am I? Your own aunt I am. Then said, you proceed forward. I'll be standing here unless you reveal me who you really are. Then Mother saw he's not going. Then he said, people say I am Mother Kali. Then Shibu said, people say, are you really Mother Kali or not? She said, then Holy Mother says, yes. Then Shibuda comes coming. That was the time Holy Mother revealed that she is none other than Mother Kali. Very few times she revealed herself through her mouth. She said, yes, she is Mother Kali. But for the devotees, she is the Divine Mother. With no head and no skull and no decapitated arms, only the boon and fearlessness, only the protection and love. That aspect of Divine Mother Kali has come to this Holy Mother, lived for a certain time in history, but ever living in spirituality and care. So worship, meditation of Divine Mother as Holy Mother will bring us closer to that ultimate reality, God, Brahman, or Divine Mother, Mother Kali.